हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो आई हैव ब्रॉट अ न्यू कस्टम रोम फॉर रेडमी 4X। दिस इज सेंटोनी। द नेम ऑफ दिस रोम इज लिनेज OS 17.1 वर्जन फॉर रेडमी 4। लेट्स हैव द स्पेसिफिकेशन। हियर द स्पेसिफिकेशन। एंड्रॉइड वर्जन 10, यू विल गेट एंड्रॉइड 10 लेटेस्ट 2905/2020 पैच, लेटेस्ट बिल्ड अवेलेबल। एंड्रॉइड सिक्योरिटी पैच 5 May 2020। Let's check the features and the bugs of this ROM. If all the feature bugs or not. Okay, let's check the Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is 100% working. Here you can see it's worked perfectly. No problem in Wi-Fi. And hotspot also working properly. There is no restart of hotspot or there is no close of hotspot during using the hotspot. It's working properly. And the Bluetooth audio device is also working properly, 100% working. And the battery backup of this ROM is amazing than any other custom ROM, Android 10 custom ROM. Here you can see battery saver and performance. You can extreme battery saver, you can enable the extreme battery saver. Let's check the display. Here is the display. Brightness level is 100% working. Here you can see the brightness level is working properly. There is no problem in brightness level, and automatic brightness level is also 100% working. And here is the dark mode available in this ROM. This is the dark mode available. This is not fully black, this is just gray mode. Here you can see turn off. Now here is pure black is also available in this ROM. Let's check the pure black also. Here is pure black. If you don't like dark gray, then you can enable pure black. It's working perfectly, no problem. Every feature is working perfectly. Live display, here is a live display. Color profile, you can change the volume to your use. Color calibration is also working perfectly, no problem. Picture adjustment is also working 100%. Here you can see, you can adjust the picture also. Here is the night mode. Night mode is also working properly, 100% working. Intensity is also working properly. You can adjust according to your use. Adaptive brightness is working properly. Full screen apps here are full screen apps. You can enable the full screen apps from here. In the left side, the lock screen display. Here is the lock screen display. Left side, the always on display. It is the always on display. It works perfectly, no problem in always on display. Here you can see it's working perfectly. There is no closure of always on display clock. It works perfectly. Light up display is also 100% working. Everything is working properly. I have tested each feature. Let's check the sound. There is the sound available in this ROM. Here you can see sound is enough loud in this ROM. There is no problem in sound. Here you can increase the sound from starting also. Vibration is also 100% working. There is no delay in vibration or any other problem in the vibrator. And the charging sound is also working, vibration 100% working. Storage is almost there are files of approximate 0.86 GB, so there is almost storage of 25 GB available in this ROM. 25 GB storage free. Here is the privacy up to 32 GB. So password, here is the privacy, you can control the privacy. Here location is also working perfectly, no problem in location. Let's check the security fingerprint, if the face unlock is available or not, and how fast is the fingerprint in this ROM. Here you can see, now let's apply the fingerprint. Fingerprint is working perfectly, no problem in fingerprint. Here you can see, done, I successfully applied. Tap, open. Fingerprint is a bit late than MIUI 11. Fingerprint is better than Android 10 ROMs. Other Android 10 ROMs like Havok, but is slower than MIUI. There is no face unlock available in this ROM. Only smart lock is available. You have to flash open gaps. There is no open gap included in this ROM, so you have to flash after the installation of the ROM. Here are the gestures. Here are the buttons option. Let's check the button. Backlight is not there in this device. Power menu, here is the power menu. You can enable lockdown, bug reporter. Here you can see long press photos, activate the torch when the display is off and cool. Everything is working perfectly. Home key, recent key, volume up key. Here you can set according to your use. Show panel on the left, you can from the right to left, left to right, you can change the panel. Here are the system profiles, status bar, let's check the status bar. Quick build down, network traffic monitor is also working perfectly. Here you can see it's come between. Here you can see it's work perfectly. Auto hide when there is no use of internet. Clock position, right center, you can adjust according to your use. Show seconds also. Here you can see it's working perfectly. Here a small PM. Now you can adjust according to your use. Here is the circle or dotted battery percentage inside. here are the geysers. There are only two geysers, not so much available in this room. Here the updater updates. You can directly update from this. I will update you if the updater app is working or not. Link will be in the description. All the files link will be in the description. You can check the description as there is the latest version already installed. So I will check the older version, then I will update in the description. Here are the apps available in this room. These are the apps. And there is a camera also available, that the quality is not so good. You can install the Gcam also. Here you can see the tab here, accessory, enter into recovery mode. After entering into recovery mode, you have to click on the backup, check system image, vendor image, data and boot. Here you have to select 4 items, then you have to swipe to backup or select the storage. Do not backup in internal storage, as internal storage will be formatted in the next step. So backup in micro SD or USB main. Okay, then you have to swipe to backup. After backup is complete, go on the home screen, click on wipe, then format data, type yes. Here internal storage will be formatted. This will take few seconds only, 5 to 7 seconds. Our internal storage will be formatted. Here you can see, now click on back, then click on advanced wipe. You have to click Dolvik system, vendor, data, cache. Here you have to select 5 items. Here you can see, then swipe to wipe. Our old ROM will be deleted successfully. Now there is no OS installed in our ROM in our device. Now click on install. You can transfer from PC to internal storage also via USB in 3D mode, or you can install via micro SD or USB. Now we have successfully entered into the BATIC recovery. Now you have to click on the install. After transferring data, here is the Linux 17.1. Then you have to select the Linux 17.1. Then you have to add more zip. Then you have to select the OpenGAPS ARM64 10.0 micro. I am using micro. OpenGAPS you can use according to your usage. Then you have to swipe to confirm the flash. Here you can see that the installation has been started. First you have to select the ROM, then you have to flash the gaps. You can flash the gaps separately also. This will take few minutes to flash. That means after the installation is completed. Now here you can see that the installation has been successfully completed. All the files, first of all our ROM has been successfully installed, then our OpenGAPS has been successfully installed. Then you have to click on the reboot system. Simply click on the reboot system, then you have to wait few seconds to get the MI logo. After getting the MI logo, you will get the Lineage OS ROM logo. This is for Redmi, for Santoni. If you want Lineage OS for other devices, then you can comment down below. I will provide you the link if it is available for your device. Here you can see that this is the logo. This is the Lineage OS 17.1 logo, Android 10 based. If you like the video, press the like button and subscribe our channel for daily updates.